here we are, getting ready for this showdown between these two fighters. Should be a good one. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Hi to everybody back home.
And now it's time for the tale of the tape. There can only be one, Lomachenko, one of the most technically skilled fighters in all of boxing. No one moves around the ring like Lomachenko.
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds.
You can tell, but... And there's the bell for round one. There's a right hand. Timing beats speed. Speed beats power. So much pre-hype surrounding this fight, the fans are on the edge of their seats.
Did you see the nerves on a fighter stepping into the ring, Tom? It can tell you so much about a fighter. And the look in the opposite corner, you've got one fighter that is in heaven. This is where they want to be.
Perfect punch. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Nice score with that left hand.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. She's like a match made in heaven.
Got out of the way of that right hook. Walk away from each other and then run right back into trouble. Both men step back for just a moment. Caught him with a heavy punch. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Talk about a one-sided 3 minutes. We just saw it.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as a fighter and a court.
Well, we've just taken a big breath, and here we go again. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there might be more action here. Counterfighter relies a lot on their instincts and reaction time. You've got to get in there quick to punch your opponent before he gets his fist back to block.
Reaction is second to none. It's the blink of an eye, and they're waiting for any little twitch you do. So you've got to fight a counterpuncher smart.
Good counter right hand again. And he fails to score with that left hook. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. What a punch.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
Left punch. No power in those punches. That punch landed. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here.
I seriously hope the judge.
And there's the bell for round three. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. He's got to find a way to get around that reach advantage.
Very smart, very sharp. This is the fit young man style that he's got to get inside that long reach. Not many fighters can do that.
He's got a massive reach advantage. Let's see if he uses it. It's defend yourself at all times, but this fighter hasn't defended themselves at all. And a counter left. That one lands. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Unlike the heavier fighters, these fighters throw so many punches, it's hard to keep up.
Oh my goodness, so that little Yorkshire Terrier is never going to give up. This is what you're going to get. You're going to get speed, good footwork. You're going to get punches thrown from head to body. You're going to get a lot of toe-to-toe. When you've got fighters at these weight divisions, they'll stand there. They don't need a ring. They need a phone box.
Nice punch. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there would be some more action here. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. Nice counter shot. On to the fourth we go. That round was complete domination. Let's see if we can shake things up here in this round.
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down.
There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
What a gift. What a gift it is to have a chin where you know you can walk through anything and everything. When you let those shots go and it's just bouncing off and they're walking you down, it's so demoralizing. It absolutely breaks your heart. What else can you do?
Good left hand. Figure out the combination to this sink. Oh, what a punch!
They're so close, so close. How can you separate them? It's gonna be a hard night tonight for the judges.
This fighter's sort of the death by a thousand paper cuts approach. He'll hit you a thousand times before you can land one.
Let me explain to you about a fast fighter that's got hand speed and footwork. They're relaxed. They're confident. They know they just have to quick burst. Boom! In a split second, they've let four shots go. Their footwork has got them out of the way. And these guys are so relaxed. And that's why they can maintain this all the way through a fight.
This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. On to the fifth we go. Coming off that great round, let's see if they can build on momentum here. Missed him with that uppercut. Which one of these athletes is going to be the first to go down? Energy and endurance are not an issue for this fighter who continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on.
How do you deal with an aggressive fighter? What you do is you fight fire with fire. You either give it them back because that's where they're comfortable, or you play calm, play cool.
Nice exchange here from both men. Punch, counter punch. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Beautiful counter punch. Good punch. Nice punch. Nice job landing that left counter punch. Trying to answer back. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. This is the beginning of round six. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. How do they use the spider's aggression against them?
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
Why are they throwing punches? They should be playing defense right now. No rest for the weary. Changes from both men in this round. He just misses with that jab. There's no doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake.
You've got to be courageous when you get in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain then.
Counter shot lands. He takes that jab. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. As bad as boxing judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that round. Here we go, it's round seven. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. That's a scoring left hand. Solid punch. Hear that old phrase, second win. You've got to find it somehow.
Now you've got two fighters that are absolutely shattered. What gets you through? Willpower. Calm, because if you panic, you get desperate. If you get desperate, you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked out.
Hey, those punches add up. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. That left shot lands. How do they use this fighter's aggression against them?
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, if you are not fit, that is the worst place to be, having second thoughts in the ring.
Neither man really defending themselves. Nice offensive display, landing that left counter. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Pretty dominant round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round.
Dominant.
Round 8, and we're off again. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Counter right. That punch lands. Heard the phrase, finding a second win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
Good counterpunching for both these athletes. It just gets out of the way of that right uppercut. Can they figure out the combination to this save?
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them more than that.
Oh, and it's flashing lights for the flash here. He's got to get out of trouble. He somehow weathered the storm. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Here from both men. Right hand. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. Well, we know they've got the advantage so far, but how does this match get turned around? See how much fatigue we see here in round 9. Coming off that great round, let's see if they can build on momentum here. There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
Don't get trigger happy, because all of a sudden you're going to be gassing yourself down trying to get that shot, and that's when they'll catch you.
They call it the chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight. Coming back to life now, starting to land some punches. Back and forth they go, neither fighter willing to back down. The old adage is, no matter how much speed you've got, timing beats speed.
You've got to ruffle their feathers, Todd. You cannot let them get comfortable, drag them, get them complaining to the referee, because once somebody with excellent foot speed and excellent power gets into the rhythm, the fight is over. I've never seen a fighter so fast in my life. How do you deal with this? You've got to hope they went out of steam.
I think it's safe to say one of these fighters certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. It's
no secret who has the advantage after that.
There's the bell for round 10. Can they seal the deal in this round after what we saw just a minute ago? Good one. Seen in the past from this fighter, they don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike at any moment.
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Coming back to life now, starting to land some punches. No Moss. These two are the perfect dance partners. Catch and shoot with the left counter. Good job. I think it's safe to say one of these fighters certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
When you have a fighter that's got that great footwork and that great hand speed, it's so hard. It's an uphill battle.
Here's a scoring blow. Nice shot with the left. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. That was almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance. And there's the bell for round 11. After a really strong round, let's see if they can finish the job. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab. It can be intimidating. Just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
Both men step back for just a moment. That left counter punch will score. This fighter realizes that defense is one of the scoring criteria in boxing. Nice counter. Why aren't they defending? Good counter punching. This fighter's sort of the death by a thousand paper cuts approach. He'll hit you a thousand times before you can land one.
When you've got a fast fighter, they will cut you to ribbons, and they know it's a matter of time before either you get desperate or the referee jumps in and saves you. This is a natural gift.
Round still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Talk about a one-sided 3 minutes we just saw.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as a fighter, and opponent's got to.
On to the 12th. Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here. He got caught. He's trying to fight his way back into this. I don't know what his game plan is, or if he's even got one. How are they still standing? one of these athletes is going to say, I can't take it anymore. Do you believe what we're seeing? How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
It's the one who draws first blood, Todd. That's what you've got to look at. If you've hit and you know you're in there with a banger, you've got to be on it, but you've got to be confident.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Defense is not an option for these two. Many of the people in the division hit like them. And that's exactly where he doesn't need to be. And apparently no rest for the weary. Thought about taking a breath, but instead, they're in there throwing bombs again. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one.
What a whitewash. You know, that's skills, that's class, that's levels. One is up there, one is down there, but you know what? The loser is going to have to learn a big, big, hard lesson. I totally agree.